Welcome to WIRIS Quizzes. In this video, we'll show some of the basics of creating a quiz, some additional validation criteria you can specify, and how to randomize values in a quiz. In the question we're editing, we've asked the students to isolate the variable y in the equation y minus x equals 2. The answer, of course, is y equals x plus 2, but we want to allow x plus 2 and 2 plus x as answers. Here's how we'll do that. We'll type the correct answer in the space provided, and then we'll switch over to the student view and enter 2 plus x as the student's answer. Then let's click test and verify our answer. And we see it is verified as correct. In the next question, we want the students to simplify a fraction. We've already given the correct answer in WIRIS Quizzes Studio. We've also specified under validation options that the student answer not only be mathematically equal, but simplified. So as a student, we'll type an answer that's mathematically correct, but not simplified. Now that's a rather silly answer, but let's check and see what happens when we click test. It's verified as mathematically equal, but it's not simplified, so the student answer is not correct. Now we'll see an example of how WIRIS Quizzes can randomize the values in a question so each student sees a different set of questions. In this question, we want them to add two fractions. Notice there are four letters with a pound sign preceding them. When a student takes the quiz, WIRIS Quizzes will replace all of these with randomly generated values based on an algorithm we provide. To enter the algorithm, we'll select Define Random Variables and Functions. The variables are already defined, and there's some simple programming you can see here, and that's the subject of a different video, so we won't cover it here. We've defined A and B to be random numbers between 1 and 3 inclusive. We've defined D to be a random number between 4 and 8. The variable SOL is our solution, which is the sum of A plus B divided by D. Students won't have the option to refresh the question to provide different values just because they don't like the ones they're presented with, but here in the demo, you can see WIRIS Quizzes randomizing the values so no two students will see the same question. We'll enter the correct answer and test it. Correct. Mathematically equal and simplified. Let's take a look at one more feature of WIRIS Quizzes. This is a new feature in WIRIS Quizzes 4. Now you can write a question that the student must answer graphically. Let's see how that works. This is the completed question, including the correct answer. How we got to that point was in WIRIS Quizzes Studio, we first chose graphic as the answer type, then entered our initial content, which was the line y equals 2x minus 4 and the point 10, 4. Over on the correct answer tab, we then drew the line representing the correct answer. We chose the validation options, so the only correct answer is the line y equals negative 1/2 x plus 9. Let's see how that looks to the student. We'll draw the line through the point 10, 4 with a slope of negative 1/2. And we'll click test to check our answer. And we see it's mathematically correct. In this video, we've seen how to allow mathematically equal responses, simplified responses, and randomized variables. We've also seen a new feature that allows graphical answers to be entered by the student. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for more tips and tutorials, or visit our website at www.wiris.com.